She couldn't make it today at the very last minute, but we do have a new member. Her name is Cheryl Lacoste, and with the addition of her, Macomb County now has two appointees to local government. She is on the Parks and Recreation Board of Fraser.
Yes!
Yes! All right.
Got that in before the harassment policy.
Yes, this is rather spectacular.
We got a lot of assistance.
What's your way? I'm gonna hear the sausage.
Big L, little A, big C, A-S-S-T.
I don't see any harassment stuff on the agenda.
It's right here, it's under number 8C.
Oh, is it?
With that, we have the most in the state of Michigan. And as far as Wikipedia is concerned, we have the most in Michigan.
Yay!
No, actually. But, and also on the subject of commission appointees, I'll be talking about it at the convention in one of the workshops we're setting up. Awesome. That's all I have for floor, but I think it's not already covered by the agenda.
I want to write up before. So previously I reported that we got approved for the Macomb County Adopt a Road in East Point.
Oh God.
And I got contacted by the counties indicating that we're no longer approved.
What?
Because apparently they don't have the authority to give us that road.
Road.
Some road in East Point that apparently is East Point Road, not Macomb County Road. She indicated they have more roads available. I need to call her during business hours, which is like government business hours.
So it's like, and the
right.
I have to prepare as soon as I want.
Yeah.
I do amend that motion that rents the stuff.
Any other taxation and rent?
I'll rent your taxation.
Anybody else for open floor?
I have some. So how do we solve the Jew problem?
God. Dude!
Wow.
Out of order!
Out of order.
This is coming up right here. That needs to be added on your harassment complaint racism policy.
I can't be racist, Jake.
You're not even black! What does that have to do with what it's not?
Yeah, I'm good on
this. This is...
All right.
Please, motion to close open floor.
Second. Favor.
Aye.
Motion to censor Danny.
I would second the motion to censor Danny.
Are you serious?
Totally moved and seconded.
All right. So that brings us to the appointments for the delegates.
Well, we have a motion was moved to second.
Sure. Now, all the withdrawn by the
motion was withdrawn.
Exactly.
Can the motion be withdrawn?
Yes.
What is the motion?
This is dilatory, so it's dilatory.
What was the motion, right?
To censure Danny's racist.
Totally joking.
Sorry.
That's what we said, not
dilatory. Did you want to do anything else instead?
No, I'm always against censoring.
No, no, thank you.
That being said,
Hey, Matt, I need another...
Oh, actually, if we have, unanimous vote, we can forego private, or what do we call it, secret ballots.
Does anybody object to the
Does anybody object to selecting the delegates with voice vote? Alright. So we'll move forward.
Open the nominations for delegates.
Motion to open the nominations for delegates.
Request for information. What is the established procedure for selecting delegates?
Everybody who wants to be a delegate, raise their hand. I will select them one by one, and we shall vote.
You will select them?
We shall select.
We'll vote on the order, but, I mean, he will compile the list of nominees.
Jesus.
Particularly the secretary.
That's pretty tough.
Well, he's fucking stuffing his face.
And then we'll vote on the, I assume, ranked choice voting.
How do we do that by voice?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Well, it will become an issue if you have more delegate slots than you have.
Do a approval.
We do approval.
Let's figure this out first.
Yeah, we should figure this out, okay?
Who is both eligible and wants to be
So I have an additional request for information before we do this.
Go ahead.
How do we handle votes for none of the above? So what if I think only, I should be the only delegate from McComb and all the fuckers and fuckers should stay home?
Well, then you would vote for yourself.
All right, we have to start making ballots now.
No, I think we can do this.
Do more than
I think if we do approve of voting, then anyone who gets majority gets on the list.
Yes, plurality vote. Let's just do top 14.
Yes, exactly. With the approval voting. Yes, the top 14 or 13 with approval voting. That's the simplest way. We can do it without ballots.
It's 13.
How do we do it?
We just, everyone can vote for whoever they want to, yes or no, and whoever gets it, and then we vote.
That's how. Yeah, I know, right?
So
the easiest thing to say is, who wants to be delegate? Longy of less than 13, say we promote to approve all of them.
All right. We're already on the agenda, so we got to follow the agenda.
So here's what we're going to do.
Me afterward.
Everybody who's eligible to be a delegate, who wants to be a delegate, please stand up.
Is that 13?
Y'all aren't going?
6, 7, 8. Okay, motion to approve all the standing people as delegates by acclamation. March 10th.
Are you going to this? Wait, we got someone else who's considering standing up, so let's give him a second.
Even if you don't go, you can be a delegate.
Yeah, you stand up and then we'll put you in as a delegate, and then if you don't go, you don't go.
I don't want to go, which is why
I can't. I don't have the money, and plus I don't have transportation to go.
Any opposed?
Alright, if no one opposes, then
she won't get sick.
I can't go to the state.
Man, what do you got there?
He's just sort of running over. I'm going to kill him. I'm carrying him.
Not that sure.
Alright. So that motion passed?
That motion passed. These are the delegates. Right. Congratulations to the class of 2018.
Be recorded.
Class 1.
Alright, now. Yeah. For alternates, I say everyone, even if you're not sure, you can make it. Anyone else who's here should at least want to be an alternate. That's my suggestion. Except for people
we
like James.
We have less than 14 wives.
13.
Well, we have 12. We have 12.
So that you won't like that one.
We have 12.
So, okay. Guess what? No,
No. You can't have no to have a spot because a vote for no to is not a vote for anyone else on the list.
Pods.
It's a vote against everyone else.
I want to pay a state.
You can leave it open now.
I can't,
if
dude.
If someone else comes along next month and wants to get a spot, then you can give it to them. They don't have to do anything. You can send the Prudential Committee an incomplete list and then completely.
I'm the one who's got to do it now.
He would have to be a Macomb member, so if he doesn't reside in Macomb,
he can still be a Macomb member.
My
pay
dues.
Send you a copy of text. So it's $10 to be a Macomb member.
I'm always a member of the open trip.
And you're probably fine.
I'm here from
Right, I'm not going to stay here. Where'd you put it?
I moved about 4 or 5 months
back. Where are you living? I'm sorry.
Thanks, Matt.
Okay. It's a mile from my work.
You were not a phone.
Yeah.
All right, you guys
are probably like, sit down, try
to maybe for a secretary to,
no, I'm sorry. Matt, can we sit down?
Yeah.
All right.
So, motion to close nomination for delegates.
Okay, hold on. All right,
let's go. Oh, yeah, good. Yeah, no. Don't care.
Check the map here.
I'll just say, let me just read them off real quick, just to make sure everybody's got listed, if you want to be listed. So we got Dave, Catherine, Ben, Nikki, John, Jim, Mike, me, Drew, Danny, Paul, and Fred.
Anybody else?
So we're going to need last names in some
of it. Oh yeah, I got last
name. He knows the last.
So you guys got one delegate spot left that no one wants to fill. So cool. That means you can leave your nominations open until next month, and if someone else wants to fill in, you know. But you can send out the list you have today to the Prudential Committee, so you get all those people on their list, and then you can add one more whenever you see fit.
As long as it's like a week before convention.
You have to be a state for 30 days.
Before the state convention.
Which is today.
You have to vote first. If you're a former state member, then you can read
at the 28th
of February. They won't sell you a membership.
If you are already a state member, you can renew at the door.
May 29th?
Yeah, you can renew.
So I'll be a new member.
There's people chomping the bit to buy him a life membership when his suspension is up. There's like 10 people who are like, I want.
Whoever is not a state member right now.
Technically, I'm last.
And a new state member, not a last state member.
Yeah.
So I'm a suspended state member.
If you've never been a state member before, the 30-day rule applies to you. If you've already been a state member, but your dues are lapsed, you can pay your dues at any time before the convention.
How often do they
pay? If you're not a state.
I don't know.
Have you ever been a member of the state return party? Okay, then to serve as a delegate, you have to get that. You have to go on their website and get your membership tonight. Because anything later than today, and you won't be eligible to serve.
Paul, I will pay your state membership.
Can I get
a I can pay it myself. All right, there you go. Thank you.
I'm a state member, so what does that mean? I'm confused over here.
It means you're definitely eligible to be a delegate and serve at our state convention. So
if he becomes a
okay, well, so he could be a delegate for a different.
Ben
will sponsor you. I will sponsor
right now on our. You were sponsoring it? That sounds beautiful. That works for me. Be like, what does that mean?
I'll pay your dues to be a member of the Macomb Party.
Yo, God bless your heart.
And then you'll be our 13th delegate.
13th delegate? Oh, that sounds wonderful.
But you have to be a member of the state. Are you a member of the state?
I'm a member of the state.
Oh, no. Yeah. Mm. Well, put him on the list then, right?
Okay.
Motion to approve Anthony, what's your name?
I'm Anthony Croft.
Anthony Croft, by acclamation.
Second.
What was that?
C-R-O-F.
All right. Any objector can block an acclamation. So it's just like, who's going to be that guy?
Is Keith in the parking lot? I was thinking that.
Alright, cool, you're in, Anthony, man. March 10th in Bath, Michigan. It's gonna be in Lansing. It's technically, I think it's Bath, but I think it's like a Lansing
race.
It's gonna be good. You've never been to an LP state convention before?
No.
Do you know
what I'm talking about?
They're blessed. They are.
Do you know what your district
is? Yeah, not really. People give you naked insulin.
Actually, yes. The last one,
Anthony, what congressional district do you live in?
I'm in the 11th.
The 11th? All right, cool.
Very cool.
Is that open
county?
No, open county.
Okay, great.
I just want to make sure.
It's up to us what we want to represent.
If we wanted to, still leave open the nomination.
We
want to represent our whole alternate.
So I say we open the nomination, and if you don't get any nominees, open it, and then leave it open so we can have nominees come in at the next meeting, or even between now and the next meeting, or we can get the new nominees. So, motion to open nominations for alternates.
Second.
We don't gotta fill the slate.
Mom's sick. I don't have a ride.
So if we get more people
and
now, and
I can't afford it right now, you know, for a full day.
If anyone can sell an alternate spot,
that doesn't need to be done.
I wish I could, but
I will stop here. We remember
how much.
We remember of
do we have any nominees? Alicia? Alicia, what's your name? Any other nominees?
I nominate our new member, Cheryl.
Don't give me a
state. I wanted to actually do the role, the membership list over there.
You're eating Cheryl, God damn it.
I need to do another one.
You look like you're a
Who? Mike.
Yeah, I have that.
Well, yeah, okay, so or something. I'm at the match, not the state. Is that a problem?
Maybe second guy.
No, you got to be a state member today, or you're not going to be eligible. You got to go online and get that today if you're a state member.
So, state today.
Yeah, we used to allow national or state, but they changed that last year. So now you have to be. Now you have to be a state member to be eligible for the state.
That's a new rule. All right, so I'm gonna do that today, then.
Definitely do it today. Today's the last day.
Anybody with a motion to begin new business?
I don't.
Is Bonnie already on the agenda?
We didn't approve her as a
motion to approve by acclamation.
Oh, yeah, second by motion.
All right.
So now we got one ultimate.
Then call.
Motion to table.
Table alternate. All right, new business. See if we're ahead of schedule or behind schedule. All right, candidate campaign status. Not really on the agenda, but I am just going to announce that I am officially collecting signatures for U.S. House of Representatives.
Awesome.
I have some for you guys to sign. I'm still trying to find, believe it or not, the state of Michigan website isn't that great.
That's not a surprise.
PDF to print out, just because it's really hard to fill out these things properly. U.S. House of Representatives.
Oh, U.S. House. Oh, I think it's a state rep. Okay, very good.
Yep.
Awesome.
So, if you live in the Republic County part of the 9th, you can sign this one, and the one underneath it is for Oakland.
You're in the southern part of the
So that means I'm not a state
limited? Your state is in the 9th, but if you change your address, you're in the 9th.
You know where M&M? That further part of
the
9th?
That's definitely the 9th.
You're running against Andy
Lutton. Some kind of Lutton.
Yeah, Sandy's son, Andy. Sanders not in this line anymore? He's in there now, but he's not running for real.
Okay.
That's the one you ran against when you were in 2014.
When do I run against? Does anybody else have anything for the candidate campaign status?
I got to explain mine earlier. I'm waiting to find out if the indictment against Bucci goes through. Because if it doesn't, I'll be running for state house. If it does, I'll be running for Cole Township trustees.
Okay.
I have the notes from the 120 political organizing meeting. You want me to?
Hey, Fred.
Hey, what's going on, Todd?
Good Friday.
Anybody got to
expect?
I might be able to do that. I don't know.
It's Holy Thursday.
Okay. So yeah, we left other dates open for us. Otherwise, we also talked about the tail light program.
Guys. That's getting kind of overpowered.
Yeah, I only heard half of that.
I am helping out with
Matt's talking right now. Hold on.
Governor, mayor.
All right. So yeah. So like I said, we're gonna do Tigers opening day for the final signature drive of before the April deadline. So we'll do that. We also talked about doing a taillight program. The DSA kind of has one where they fix your taillight for free. They do it as a preventative to get police encounters. Thinking that, you know, if we take care of things that cause these police encounters, you know, fix small stuff like that, you might kind of help people not encounter police. So we're gonna look at doing something like that also.
Does anybody know how to change headlights?
I do.
Alright.
Yeah.
All day long.
It depends on the car.
Well, headlights are harder, as we discussed. Taillights are usually pretty easy, but...
I missed the beginning. We're talking about things we can do to avoid people getting harassed by the cops.
Yes.
Did anyone bring up killing cops?
Joe, it's not killing if it's in self-defense.
Well, it's killing. Fine, I'm self-defense.
I don't think Nick's okay.
All right, that takes care of everything. Oh, did we want to set a date to try to do this killing thing?
Oh, man, I was loose.
Well, we don't
want to
wait for warmer weather.
I said same
thing.
Yeah,
one there going
on the video.
Yes, please.
So we kind of have a better idea what the weather's going
to be. Yeah, so maybe we'll. I mean, they said we want to do something before the August primary. I was suggesting, so maybe we'll try planning it around then. That'll be our event. Maybe we'll tie it in with something else.
And also, I found a really good parking lot with high traffic and lots of room is Coonan's on Grossbeck.
Ooh. Email Kokesh about that.
Okay.
I want to know about that.
Is that the one he got caught in?
Sounds like a nice parking lot. Yeah, a really big parking lot that has a lot of traffic going by. So
yes, more. No, I'm not done yet.
Alright, and...
it's
drinking.
Yeah.
I shouldn't drink if I have a germ. That's my new rule.
Thanks, Matt.
Let's move on to the outreach committee meeting.
Did anyone go to that?
We were actually going to go, but it was snowing, so I worked.
Yeah. Is this the same party thing? The outreach committee is just our little side thing. Just trying, like,
did we actually ever plan or schedule?
Yeah, we did.
And yeah, we were starting that year.
All right.
Yeah.
Definitely. And then. All right, so we really kind of didn't have much. We do have to schedule the next social meeting, which would be the last Saturday of this month. Anybody have any suggestions?
Later
back.
Oh,
we're at
Smokebox
Pot.
Yes!
Yeah.
I've got enough
Saturday the 24th.
You've got enough pot for 5 people?
No, I got enough laser tag stuff for 5 people.
I've got an Alpha right now.
Is that like...
But cross the cross wall.
Yeah, I can think of it in my head.
So you can call them and make a reservation and get Matt to send it out.
Alright.
Probably send it out. Yeah.
You can do it? I don't know.
Where the laser tag place.
Where's the owl?
No, it's on a ground. It's a
laser tag.
Laser cost
or something.
Oh, the one off of
John. Ratchet.
Ratchet. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. I basically
15 miles.
Yeah.
Well, that's right. Yeah. Some.
What?
Yeah.
Oh. No, the shooting happened over on Mount.
What's on the south side?
It was the Gratiot AMC.
Oh, it was the Gratiot? I thought it was the
AMC.
Tide bottom fell on Gratiot.
Oh, thanks, sir.
Woo!
Here's
all
you like.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Awesome.
His telephone number is 1-800-FREE now.
The Gratiot AMC?
Gratiot AMC. Yep, there was a shooting.
Oh!
Okay.
We'll nail down the address and the time out to put out an announcement.
Saturday 24th, Lady Day?
Yep.
Alright, motion approved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Laser tag got the best vote so far. Okay, and we have Matt's proposal for the formation of an LMC harassment slash complaint policy.
Do we have a writing?
I did write a little something. Now basically, this happened, we lost a member due to something that we're not even aware of. We should know who to tell or what happened. So this is basically a proposal to form a committee to create a harassment policy for libertarians of Macomb County. The goal of the policy would be to give members who encounter other members speaking or acting in inappropriate ways a procedure to follow. Procedures should protect the anonymity of parties at the discretion of the victim and assuming no actual crime is committed. Policy should include safe, regularly updated contacts to present complaints to, as well as lay out expectations of mutual respect during the LMC business and social gatherings. The committee will serve as a planning and organizing structure to create the policy. The proposed policy will then be presented to the LMC body for consideration to adopt as official policy for conflict resolution, member safety, and cases of harassment. The final policy should reflect our goals for retaining membership, provide a safe environment for organizing, and work through conflict as a team. This should not be seen as an attempt to police language or restrict ideas, but to constructively and formally address problematic and potentially threatening behavior, potentially opening up dialogue for greater understanding of ourselves.
Or I guess it's the same one.
Yes, I'd like to change this amendment to the Danny.
There wasn't a motion to
Danny
amend.
Policy, sorry.
I mean, you didn't make a motion.
You made a motion to adopt.
Motion,
well,
yes.
But just to form the committee, if we have people interested.
Motion to second. Form the committee.
Second.
All those in favor?
I'd like to speak.
Aye.
All right.
I think that right now we're having a lot of problems in our society with harassment, specifically sexual harassment, everything from Weinstein to Louis C.K.
To Scott Baio.
Exactly. And Kevin Spacey, Danny Blodgett, and everyone in between. I think that it sends a bad signal for the LP to jump on the bandwagon of what's turning into...
I'll tell you about that later.
And while I do agree that harassment shouldn't be acceptable, I think a formal policy often can be used against its intentions to facilitate a witch hunt against people who aren't doing any harm. So that's why I'm against the formal adoption of a harassment policy.
Well, this isn't the adoption of a policy, it's a adoption, it's a formation of a committee to...
I would like to
step towards.
So it's a complaint process. The number of complaints against do not outweigh the number of false accusations or atrocities against an innocent person. It isn't happening.
Yet.
Yet. When it does, all of us in this room will be like, hey, that's bullshit. We need to stand against it. But that is not happening now.
I get it.
So, when somebody says they have a complaint, whether you want to laugh them off or not, at least listen to them. Maybe there's a misunderstanding. Maybe there's a conflict in between characters. But we shouldn't just offhand not have any procedure or any recourse for somebody that feels they've been slighted. That's all I can say.
I'd like to speak in favor of someone who's picked up. It's just a personal one speaking.
Any further in opposition?
I'm in opposition.
My only opposition to this is the way that the proposal here, from this committee, is worded. I haven't seen the wording. Indicates the line, assuming no actual crime has been committed. I think the word crime means something very different to the majority of the legal population to what it means to the majority of libertarians. And rather than getting into what is the definition of crime, I would assume that we want to still preserve and protect the anonymity of the desires of the victim, regardless of whether or not the alleged crime has occurred.
Yeah, and like I said, this is just kind of...
Wait.
Sorry, can I see the language?
Yeah.
And if it's amendable, yes.
This is just my ideas behind it. It's not like I want to adopt this policy.
Yeah.
This is just
my thoughts behind it that I wanted to share.
That seems
and,
like something.
And this is stuff that I'll definitely want to do with Mark on it, and we'll keep it in mind. But
not about that.
What is this thing about?
It got really serious.
I put that in because just, you know, liability, I guess. You know, you assume it's an actual crime he's been committed.
Motion to amend strike everything after victim until the period. So the sentence just reads, this procedure should protect the anonymity of all parties at the discretion of the victim.
Yeah.
What was the old wording?
And assuming no actual crimes have been committed, just strike that part.
I second the amendment.
I would, all those in favor of the amendment on the proposal?
Aye.
Aye.
All right. Any more thoughts either way on the actual proposal to form the committee?
One to speak against.
Yeah, no. I'd like to speak in favor of some.
Yeah, Phil just spoke against.
So,
it should be James' turn first.
I think that just having a place.
No, I'm actually in favor.
Are you speaking in favor or against?
Against.
Then you go after.
So it's got to go back and forth. So he got to speak in favor and then you need to speak in favor.
Right.
Yeah. This is just creating a place for people to go. This isn't implementing anything.
It's creating a committee.
It's just being like, hey, it's.
One of the committee steps. So we need a committee to create an email.
I mean, the committee won't be necessarily who's going to oversee the policy or anything. It's just to create it and just kind of present it.
It's just a committee.
Work together.
I am leery of any policy that isn't maximum recognized. Jeff, sorry.
And I would assume that a good way to shape the policy would be to be on the committee.
Yeah. But there needs to be some sort of something, I guess, for if there's complaints being filed and we're losing members over it without a judicial committee, which would be probably the who would handle this. So, I mean, it's pretty much need a judicial committee or this. And I think Livingston County is the only one that has a judicial committee on the county level.
Point of inquiry, has there been like a survey or sort of an inquiry as to how many people are dropping out of the party or out of our county party due to complaints of sexual harassment? I mean,
I don't know that there's been a, you know,
it's a harassment.
We'll never know if we don't have something to point numbers to say this is where you would bring us, you know.
And I would think that we would also just need checks and balances with their.
You could just form a judicial panel. And that handles everything.
Well,
absolute power.
Danny was impressed.
Yeah. We give Danny the floor, and we're going to take this to a vote. Unless, is it a question?
Can we?
Okay. Nikki's for.
My contention with this notion is that A, we're forming what I would argue another government committee. Second, how do we go about managing this committee? Is what they say enforceable? And who enforces it?
It's not necessarily the committee that's doing the enforcing, it's the committee which is deciding what that policy is.
So
to
those committee members can have a biasness, right? They can be, let's say the committee is full of feminists or socialists. I mean, they could be hypersensitive to any guy saying slightly anything off, right? So
it would be subject to approval of the main body at the next meeting or whenever they have a proposal to bring to it.
Ah, okay. So more democracy for us.
This is just to craft the policy.
This is to be clear, this is a committee to propose a policy.
Right.
Point of inquiry.
But all policies would have to be adopted by the body.
Why? Do you feel more comfortable with
to create and propose?
They can't propose it until it's been created. It's not like there is
going to be. So we have to impose this committee if it is created. Is that what I'm gathering?
If the committee is created and it comes up with a proposal that is not up to snuff with the rest of the body, it will be voted down and nothing will have come of it.
So the body has to accept it regardless, right? So every individual has to accept these terms.
No, it would have to be done as a resolution or a bylaws amendment. I would say a bylaws amendment probably.
So
that would require probably 2/3.
So democracy
at the next convention.
Yeah.
Okay, this is fantastic.
Everything's a state of a democracy, you're damn.
Fuck democracy.
Okay.
I would like to speak in support of this. Whether you think it's silly or not, there are some pretty obvious, legitimate reasons why people leave or are reluctant to join in the first place. And nobody wants to talk about it. For example, I had a candidate for LNC chair, Alita Kamen, because every time a Republican leaves a party, everyone throws a shit. Anytime anyone's left leaning, if you want to join or leaves, nobody bats an eye. It's not necessarily about sexual harassment, it's just when we're creating disenfranchised voters, then we have problems. I don't see any harm in creating an environment where people can discuss it and not feel fear of not have fear of retaliation. It's not going to hurt anybody. Discussion never hurts. And if it does, well, maybe you should take some criticism.
I got
a
point of inquiry.
Todd had a point of inquiry.
Okay, if we're going to create this committee, will it be fair and impartial and not take any sides when there are any complaints filed?
It depends on who's on the committee. The committee's not taking complaints.
Yeah, I assume the committee is going to come with a proposal, and the committee will have thought up that proposal whichever way they spitballed it, but then whichever that proposal is, it has to be adopted as pretty much a bylaw. And if the proposal is kangaroo
courts, I'm just being theoretical
we'll
here.
Vote it down. If the proposal is harassment complaints at macombLP.com that nobody checks, it probably gets approved as very ineffective. But either way, the committee might not exist as a part of this proposal. The proposal just might be a protocol in place. And I think we already have some templates that are being used in other organizations simply to have a checks and balance, especially if, say, the proposal is complain to the chair. Well, what if the chair is the one harassing you? What do you do next?
This proposal to form a committee to create a policy, it says propose a policy, and then include language that it requires a two-thirds, or it's a bylaw, or however this is going to be.
Yeah, and you could to propose a policy to be adopted as a bylaw. How about that?
Appropriate.
All those in favor of the amendment?
Can I give a specific language?
Amendment as amended? Okay, then it would say this proposal is to form a committee to propose a harassment policy for the Libertarian Macon County that would be a...
To propose an amendment to the LMC bylaws to create a harassment policy? Okay, I second the amendment.
All those in favor of the amendment?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, all those in favor of the proposal?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All right, do we have any volunteers to serve on the committee?
Aye.
I do.
Matt, are you getting all these? Everybody
no,
hey,
Matt.
I
think we should
I'll
vote
serve.
To handle the committee immediately if we got volunteers here.
I think... should we just do it? We'll set a date for a committee meeting, and
yeah. Are we just taking everyone who raised their hand is on, or
it's a voluntary committee.
Yeah, if you want to be on it,
does this committee have to be public or
five? No, we can do it on a chat. We can come to my living room. I don't give a shit.
Appoint a
chair.
I'll be on the committee.
Appoint a chair.
Make sure I got everybody in their first order. So Jeff, Ben.
Nikki, me.
Alicia. Make a motion to appoint Matt Keno as chair of the harassment policy committee.
Second.
Is that in order?
Those are unanimous.
Yeah. All right. All those in favor of appointing Matt the chair of the committee, you propose.
Aye.
Just so I have it, who voted against the amendment?
No one.
Anybody?
Dane?
Yeah, he didn't ask.
You didn't ask.
It clearly won a majority from the
end. Oh, was that for the amendment?
Yeah.
The last
The amended.
Do you have?
He didn't ask for no against the motion either, but it was probably just gonna be me and Danny. So.
Did somebody correct the language on the segments?
Yes.
I thought he was writing it down.
Now, I want to be on the committee, I'll tell you guys right now, because I want to make sure this policy is as lenient as possible. Just telling you
and that's the purpose of the committee.
Right.
That's my goal, is to make it as lenient as possible.
Trials by combat.
Actually,
yeah.
Just letting you guys know going in.
The purpose of the committee is to take all the input and to form a policy that which works best.
I think it's a great idea to have a policy other than just a couple of balls on the juice.
Yeah, that's definitely good. Okay,
we want to steer people away from the craft.
Bring us to the reports. First with the membership director, Ben.
We're only on the number.
We have a new member,
of course.
Actually, we have two new members.
Nothing to do with me, because everybody that talks to me wants to cull the population. So, please, for fuck's sake.
Yes.
Replace me with a person of color or somebody that doesn't
know.
Danny?
No,
please.
For God's sake. He's out of the room. He didn't hear. No one's
that going. Would be fucking better. I'm not fucking kidding, dude. I've talked to
I will take over as membership director.
But I talked to veterans. I talked to masons. I talked to fucking political leaders.
We got the door open.
The door's open.
Ben.
Yeah, well, guess what?
Should I close
they tell me that they literally want to start a third world war. These are the white nice people that don't say shit
like
you.
Tell them to
they talk to me. I do.
Oh, okay. So,
when somebody walks up to me,
they
assume
a dude with a beard.
I'm going to be on their side. Well, I'm fucking not. And that is the vast majority of people in this county. And I'm fucking sorry. I tried. I put a year in. I tried. I talked to hundreds of fucking people, and every goddamn time.
But you got sausage.
It was. Every goddamn time, the conversation led to Republicans not wanting brown people around. And that's just how it is. I'm sorry. I wanted to be different. I thought I could do things differently.
Don't fucking apologize.
Great job.
Yeah,
great. Look, Ben, don't apologize, for Christ's sake.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
You've got more members per capita in Cole than just about any other county that I can
tell. How do these conversations go then to World War III?
You don't do it.
But you just said that everybody you talk to wants to start World War III.
Yes. I'm talking the people that lead 5 to 10 of the Masonic temples in this county.
Okay.
No, I will never be a mason. I know many masons.
Can you do me a favor and package my potato and my meat?
Discuss with them. They talk about killing people. No? Okay then.
Then
happened.
Permission.
We didn't vote for Trump in this county. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. Go ahead, think in what you're thinking.
Ben, hey Ben, when are you moving?
As soon as fucking possible.
Don't leave. Where are you going?
I don't fucking know. Not here.
I know I'm new to the group, but talk to me before you leave.
Yeah, for sure.
I'll talk about taking over your role.
Yeah, for sure.
Just to warn everybody.
Absolutely.
I will try to recruit from the left just as
much
as the right.
You're going to have a fucking headache, but I will help you in every way that I can. I will tell you everything that I know.
No Nazis, please.
Yes.
For fuck's sake, dude. I'm not even kidding.
So, even though we haven't announced it yet, I think fitting in with our, you know, second Wednesday formula, we would have to call our next convention to be by at least April 11th in order to fit with the state bylaws going into the next state
thank
convention.
You.
What? Why?
That's the math I worked out with, right?
Really?
Oh, why?
You need another county convention in 2 months?
Well, that's why I was calling this a delegates convention or a delegates caucus. And April 11th, we'll have to re-elect all
gonna
our...
You're going to select the delegates for August?
No, we're going to vote on our bylaws and select new officers.
Okay, well, that's different. Why not?
That's our convention.
Okay. So that's basically your bylaws, when your convention has to be...
No, there's some other
that
reason why.
That doesn't have to be a convention. That can be a regular meeting.
No, according to our bylaws, it has to be. And then.
Well, when is the state convention?
What the hell is the
actual?
There is no actual difference procedurally. Yeah. It's just what you call it.
Okay.
I'll be back with that.
Yeah, do their bylaws call for their officers' elections to be at a convention? Because
well, Jeff, I have a copy of the bylaws here.
Jim's got one he's reading right now, so he's going to figure it out for us. Just like we had our officers' elections on our bylaws and platform at a regular meeting.
Who's your officer?
James got re-elected as chair, I got re-elected as treasurer, Roger Young's vice, and then Carl Pumper secretary.
You
want to be media director?
All that means is social media.
Oh, the reason why we wanted to have it then was to have it in time to include all other possible candidates before the filing deadline.
The filing deadline is April 24th.
Yeah. Oh. So we want to have a convention by April 11th.
You know, there's a caucus for candidates? Is that
just,
what you're saying?
Just to, A, get the new officers all set, and something to do with the next day convention is something to do with Greg wanting to do something or something. Right.
So you don't actually have to.
I was going to recommend you for the membership director position.
We have to have to hold it before the August 9th.
Okay.
So we'll move into next meeting to Valentine's.
I was going to recommend you for membership director position.
Well, he was already coming to the
office.
So that's why you leave that.
Okay.
All right. Development director, Nikki.
What did they do?
Well, obviously, Ben and I are moving, so development director will be another one that needs to be filled. And,
Okay, and see, here's another reason to have the convention. Fill in these two spots. Okay. Treasure report, Dan.
Serious note, right? We need to know because we're going to throw you guys at least.
Communications? Skipping that?
Oh, I'm sorry. Communications director, John.
I've talked to people.
I stopped.
Serious note? No, I don't really have anything to. Report right now. I've just been trying to make it day by day right now.
All right.
Well, that must be. I'm trying.
All right, treasury report, Dave.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, we're a balance of $463 in two accounts, the check-in and the savings account. The savings is not up to date on the machine. Full government credit union report. So here's the cost of the year.
Plus the two members.
Nice boss.
Plus the two new members and whatever we're going to have for that.
Are these both the same?
Yeah. So. That's our.
Okay. Vice Chair report, Todd.
Okay. Well, I'm still trying to. I'm asking for articles and picks and stuff like that for the newsletter, if we can get that underway.
State or county newsletter?
We're trying to get that underway.
What type of articles would you be interested in?
Everything that's happening at the Macomb County level.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No Tide Pods.
I got a bunch of those.
Oh, you do? Well, send them my way. Well, anyway, yeah. Well, anyway, I'm trying to get articles together. Nikki, I don't know how long you're going to be wanting to do this. I hope that we can get something out before you go.
Honestly, if there are other people that want to be involved, I can
We need contact information, and I agree with Catherine right there. You know, I need ideas for, you know, what's going on, like events, what people are doing, like college campus events, you know, Operation Politically Homeless, that sort of thing. And that's pretty much about it. I don't have anything else to report.
All right.
Oh, an addendum. I'm looking for speakers as usual. Anybody got any ideas for speakers that might be interested in coming? Anybody you know at the state level coming down to our area, please send them our way.
All right, me to report. The coolest thing I had to report isn't here right now, which is now we got a Parks and Rec person. Cheryl, want to keep on encouraging everybody to keep an eye open for openings on committees. They're not super glamorous, but.
There was one at Macomb County Mental Health Board. I saw it. It was end of this month. You have to be receiving mental health care, I'm sure. I'm not going to have a resume.
Work.
All right. And, I just want to keep on encouraging everybody. Now we got another social meeting planned. A lot easier to bring friends to a social event. And then if there's anybody you know who, you know, just wants to come to a regular business meeting, but, you know, you can let them know they don't need to participate. If they're not joining, they really can't participate unless they're, just to bring people around, basically. Keep that going, and glad that we have all of our delegates to the state convention, and see you guys all there, I guess. I guess we'll have one more meeting. No, we will.
Before the convention?
No, we won't.
Right after?
I got a question.
Yeah.
What is the deadline for the state convention for the signup for the state? So is it at midnight? Or?
Midnight.
Come on.
Did I leave here?
So here's the honest truth, Anthony. I'm on the state credentials committee. If you don't mind.
Go ahead.
You've already signed your national membership sometime. At least this year, I'm pretty sure we're going to allow the waive the 30-day membership thing.
That's what the state chairman said.
So if you don't get it in by tonight, I wouldn't worry about it.
Oh. Okay.
If you got $25 and can do it tonight, that'd be awesome.
Oh.
But don't lose sleep over it.
I'll try not to.
He gave me $25 a month ago. I just lost it. I'll get it to you as soon as I find it.
You seem funny, right?
Right?
Isn't that what you said?
It's well, gotta be for the state.
I'm not the main too.
Yeah. No, he's funding you for county.
County membership.
You're a county member.
Oh, county membership.
They mean
memberships, is it?
It's so too many. This is. Yes, our organization is more complicated than most.
Three levels of membership.
I haven't been open for it.
All right. Is there anything that you can sign for all of them?
That's no, unfortunately. They claimed that it was a violation of federal
law. We're decentralized.
You're a decent, that's a true thing. Fractured more like this. All right, we got some more open floor.
I have a couple of comments. Last month's meeting was
awesome. I love
it. It was eventful. I wish it had gone a little smoother and a little better, but it is what it is. and I'm glad we got everything out in the open. I don't know if everybody had seen the video I put up on YouTube. I put it on there, let everybody, you know, I put like a standard version and an HD version, and everybody was like, well, some people probably watched it and they were like, my God, that's how they run meetings, that's great. And some are probably thinking, well, that was a disaster. And I'm sure some people feel that way, but you know, I don't care what people think. I did as much as I could out of that one. I mean, I tried to put everything all together. I mean, I was thrusted into it at the last. So, I did the best I could under the circumstances.
So you're blaming Mike, man. That's
like a mistake, this and that.
Damn it! All
right, you guys have.
You weren't even drinking. Well,
you should have seen.
I'm Jim Fuller. As you may or may not know, I was selected as the LPM's representative on the National Platform Committee. So if any of you have any issues with our national platform, you wish it said this, you wish it didn't say that.
They just say runs of stuff.
Yes.
Please talk to me, and I will be happy to propose any changes to the committee, even if I don't agree with them.
That is right.
Bring back the child's rights plank from the 80s. I will certainly do what I can if there's support for the membership. The committee is currently considering an in-person meeting. We're currently leaning towards in Columbus, Ohio in May. I was also the representative 2 years ago in St. Louis. Not until I got there that I found out any members are welcome to come if you really want to see how the sausage is made. So I'll say that if it isn't within driving distance, anybody who wants to fit in my electric car is welcome to, you know, come along and...
Did we get a piece of that sausage?
Where's that sexual harassment?
One more thing I wanted to bring up too, and it's a little bit different. I'm working on Brian Ellison's campaign. He's looking for signatures and whatnot. James is... he's the manager, and yeah, we're looking to get his campaign and gear and everything. I heard that they redid the website and all. So if we can get him on the ballot and go up against the likes of, say, that Republican Senate candidate and Debbie Stabenow, that would be awesome.
If anybody from Macomb or Oakland hasn't signed for Brian yet, I have two of his petitions here.
So your petitions are all destroyed, right? So I can now sign his?
I think they're actually in the back of my side.
So is
it. Okay. So they'll never see the light of day.
I have a lighter, James.
All right, Jeff.
All right, start me.
I just want to talk about some stuff going on at the state party level right now. There's kind of like a, what I'm calling a media blackout. They put out these really restrictive rules for getting an article published in the newsletter or on the new website. They put out a set of policies just in the last week Jimmy Yao came up with for how to get something published. But if you read through these new rules, they're ridiculous. You can't say anything bad about another candidate. You can't campaign. You can't ask for money. You can't do any of these things. And I really think that it's a waste, especially if this is our first primary.
Is Tim Yao another candidate or another candidate at all?
He's a freedom
ninja.
They said any other candidate, but I think they were specifically referring to libertarian candidates, but that's what I was just getting into. This is our first ever primary. This is an opportunity, James, just saying. This is our opportunity to get attention for ourselves before the primary by showing the people that are going to be voting for us what kind of libertarian we are by differentiating ourselves from other libertarians, but they don't want to allow that at all at the state party level. They want to make it seem like we're all just friends, we're all getting along, we don't disagree on anything, so I just want to...
What was this put out?
The rules?
Yeah,
the
website?
The newsletter rules were put out like a month or so ago, right when they restarted the newsletter, and the rules for the website just came out last week. Tim Yao is holding a training session for anyone who wants to learn how to follow his rules for how to publish. And like I said, it's just really troubling. I think that we need to be taking advantage of primary season because this is our first opportunity to take advantage of primary season. And just this idea that we're not allowed to criticize each other is ludicrous.
I would love for one.
Do either any of our opponents do that? I'm guessing the Democrat president didn't do that on the Democrat website.
No, of course the Democrats, the Republicans, tear into each other.
But not on their party's website.
I mean, they're saying they won't even, they don't share articles from candidates often there. It's mostly opinion pieces from non-candidates.
Well, they won't even share fucking that Brian Ellison was endorsed by Joe Exotic on the Facebook page.
It's really outrageous.
With that subject in mind, or a broader range of subjects, if anybody ever has anything that they want, put forward, the LEC, obviously me and John are both representatives.
Put that forward. Put it forward that they need to put on the shit that Brian Ellison was.
How many beers are in that?
Put that on the shit.
I thought that was a rhetorical put that forward for a second. That's what she said?
I do intend to make a motion to rescind the rules so that we can come up with... I mean, these rules weren't put together by the LEC.
The published candidate...
This is something that was cooked up by a single individual at our party who really wants to present things as if we only have one candidate in our important offices because they don't want secondary candidates getting any attention. So I think that it's important for the LEC to get rid of these restrictive rules.
I definitely need to look into the verbiage.
Yeah. Motion to censure.
I'll send you the website and the newsletter.
Motion to censure what?
You see the language, you can tell they were written by the same person.
All of
them. All those in my assumption is very
Aye.
My assumption is that it probably came straight from Bill.